So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to another session of PIB 247. Main hu Manish Mishra and in today's session we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news which are important for the ESI section of RBI Grade B and NABARD. So let's begin with the session guys, but before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon. You can also join this Telegram group for daily quizzes and updated information regarding the daily sessions and also about the courses. So let's begin with the very first question, which says NHPC Private Limited and Dash State Power Development Corporation Limited has formed a joint venture company for the implementation of Rattle Hydroelectric Power Corporation Limited. It is in fact a company which is known as Rattle Hydroelectric Power Corporation Limited. Okay, and it is for implementing Rattle Hydroelectric Power Project. All right. So let's talk about this. So NHPC has formed a joint venture company for the implementation of 850 megawatt Rattle Hydroelectric Power Project, and this has been done with Jammu and Kashmir State Power Development Corporation Limited, with a holding of 51% by NHPC and 49% by Jammu and Kashmir State Power Development Corporation Limited. All right. So 51% share kiska NHPC ka aur baki 49% is company ka. Remember, this project is located on River Chenab and an estimated cost for this project is how much? 5281.94 crores rupees. Ye amount aapko yaad rakhne ki zarurat nahi hai. Here in this news, you just have to remember that the Rattle Hydroelectric Project is located on the River Chenab. It can be asked in your phase 1. And then you have to remember what is the percentage of equity, 51% and 49% of NHPC and the company. And of course, jo project hai uska naam. Alright. And therefore guys, the correct answer should be what option A, Jammu and Kashmir. Jammu and Kashmir is the correct answer. NHPC Private Limited and Jammu and Kashmir State Power Development Corporation Limited has formed this joint venture company. Alright. And now let's move ahead to question number 2, which says, consider the following statements with regards to black carbon and you have to identify the correct statement. So black carbon ke regarding, you have to identify the correct statement. Now why we are discussing about the black carbon, the question is this. We are studying is about the black carbon because recently there is a study which has been published in the Asia Pacific Journal of Atmospheric Sciences, and this study says that the accurate estimation of black carbon is now possible using the optical instruments in the Himalayan region. हिमालयन रीजन में ऑप्टिकल इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स का इस्तेमाल करके एक्यूरेट एस्टिमेशन ऑफ ब्लैक कार्बन इज नाउ पॉसिबल. एंड रिमेंबर, ब्लैक कार्बन गाइस इज द सेकंड मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट ग्लोबल वार्मिंग पोल्यूटेंट आफ्टर CO2. नाउ कैन यू टेल मी विच इज द फर्स्ट मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट ग्लोबल वार्मिंग पोल्यूटेंट? राइट डाउन इन द कॉमेंट्स. लेट अस सी कि आप में से कौन इस क्वेश्चन का जवाब दे पाता है. एंड देयर इज वन थिंग विच इज नोन एज मास एब्जॉर्प्शन क्रॉस सेक्शन, MAC, विच इज एन एसेंशियल पैरामीटर विच इज यूज फॉर ऑब्टेनिंग ब्लैक कार्बन मास कॉन्सेंट्रेशन. बेसिकली मास एब्जॉर्प्शन क्रॉस सेक्शन इज वॉट थ्रू दिस टेक्निक, थ्रू दिस मेथड वी मेजर द एब्जॉर्प्टिविटी एफिशियंसी ऑफ द ब्लैक कार्बन. जो ब्लैक कार्बन की मास एब्जॉर्प्टिव कैपेसिटी है उसको मेजर किया जाता है थ्रू दिस पैरामीटर. एंड विच आर द कोलैबोरेटिंग बॉडीज? So these are scientists at the ARIES, which is an autonomous institute under the Department of Science and Technologies. Scientists from Delhi University, IIT Kanpur and Space Physics Laboratory, ISRO. And ye jo study mein kuch highlights bhi thi news mein, but that is not important for the ESI section of our exam. That is important for the UPSC. So we will not discuss that highlight. Alright. So let's come back to the question. We have to identify the correct statement regarding black carbon. So black carbon is the second most important global warming pollutant after CO2. That's absolutely correct. And you have to tell which is the first most important. Write down in the comments. Mass absorption cross section, MAC, is an essential parameter used for obtaining black carbon mass concentration. This is absolutely correct once again. And accurate estimation of black carbon is possible using optimal instruments in the Himalayan region as this study suggests. This is also correct. Accurate estimation of black carbon is not possible. So this is incorrect guys, using optical instrument. So this is incorrect and 1, 2, 3 are absolutely correct, which means option A only, 1, 2 and 3 will be the correct answer. I hope guys this question is clear and this is directly related to the environmental economics, jisme hum global warming ka jo effect wagera hai wo bhi padhte hain, black carbon ki utility ke bare mein ya fir jo carbon emission hai uske bare mein bhi padhte hain. Alright. And now let's move ahead to question number 3. और आजकल RBI का कोई भरोसा नहीं है कहाँ पे क्या क्या क्वेश्चन पूछ लेता है, जैसे कि हमने लास्ट ईयर के एग्जाम में देखा था. सो ज्यादा से ज्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट चीजें हम कवर करेंगे इन दीज सेशंस. ऑलराइट. So the next question is, the Supreme Court has released the draft model rules for live streaming and recording of court proceedings. Question is, which of the following is not correct regarding this draft? So be a draft model rules for live streaming and recording of the court proceedings. You have to identify the incorrect statement regarding this. Now let's talk about this draft model rules for live streaming. So the Supreme Court has released this draft model rules for live streaming and recording of court proceedings, and these are the part of national policy and action plan for implementation of ICT in the judiciary. Judiciary mein ICT ke implementation ke liye ek national policy and action plan banaya gaya tha by the government. Uska ye rules part hain, and this rule would cover high courts, lower courts and tribunals. High court ko, lower court ko, tribunal ko ye rules cover karenge. And there are some cases where these live streaming rules will not be applicable, like matrimonial disputes, gender-based violence, cases involving minors, cases which may provoke enmity among the communities, and cases which involve the sexual offenses. So these are the cases which have been excluded from the live streaming rules. And who will be the deciding authority that whether a case will go through the live streaming or the recording or not? So there will be a bench that will be constituted. Ek bench banai jayegi, and that bench will decide that whether a particular case will go for the live streaming or for the recording or not. And the decision of this bench will be final and shall not be justiciable. Ye jo decision hoga bench ka, ye final hoga aur justiciable nahi hoga. Yani aisa nahi hoga ki agar kisi bench ne koi decision diya regarding this live streaming, to uske khilaf hum aage higher court mein chale jaye, aisa possible nahi hai. Alright. And the rules also allows for objections to be filed against live streaming in specific cases at the stage of filing of the case. Agar jab case file ho raha hai, usi stage pe aapko objection dalni hai, toh you can file the objection at the case of filing. Alright, or at a later stage also, but only in the some specific cases. Alright, all cases it is not allowed. Okay. And the draft rules allows for archiving of court proceeding for 6 months. Jo court proceedings hai, uski archiving 6 mahine ke liye ki jayegi, uske baad us record ko delete kar diya jayega. Okay. And there are some restrictions also. Restrictions ki baat karte hai. So there will be no telecast of discussions matter between judges and advocates. So jo bhi discussions honge between the judges and the advocates and the note made by judges, that will not be telecasted. Alright. Other than this, there will be no telecast on media without permission. If any court proceeding, if any live streaming, if any person wants to telecast on media, then a permission is required from the judiciary. And there is no provision for commercial use, which means recordings shall not be used for the commercial or promotional purposes. Okay. Yani ki aisa nahi hona chahiye ki koi particular advocate hai, agar wo koi case jeeta hai, to wo jaake us case ki जो लाइव स्ट्रीमिंग है वो यूट्यूब अपने यूट्यूब चैनल पे डाल रहा है तो टू गेन दी यू नो ऑडियंस. ऑलराइट, दैट इज नॉट अलाउड. सो दिस वाज अबाउट दिस न्यूज एंड नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन. एंड रिमेंबर देयर वाज अ केस ऑफ स्वप्निल त्रिपाठी वर्सेस सुप्रीम कोर्ट ऑफ इंडिया. उस केस के बाद, आफ्टर दैट केस, दीज ड्राफ्ट मॉडल रूल्स हैव बीन यू नो ड्राफ्ट मॉडल रूल्स जो है उसके बाद ही बनाए गए हैं. ओके, सो देयर वाज अ केस स्वप्निल त्रिपाठी वर्सेस सुप्रीम कोर्ट ऑफ इंडिया. This case is the principle, this case is the base of these rules. Okay, so let's talk about which of the following is not correct. So live streaming proceedings are the part of right to access justice under Article 21. This is absolutely correct. Under Article 21 of the Constitution of India, we have the right to access justice, and the live streaming proceedings are the part of that right. So Swapnil Tripathi versus Supreme Court of India principles are the base of the model rules of the draft. Yes, as I told you, discussion between judges and advocate will not be telecast. This is absolutely correct. And proceeding instituted under section 376, that means rape, which of course involve the sexual offences of IPC, will not be live streamed. This is also correct, which means all are correct, should be the correct answer. No statement is incorrect here. Okay. So option E will be the correct answer. And now let's move ahead to question number 4, which is the last question for today. Niti Aayog has launched Surakshit Hum Surakshit Tum Abhiyan in 112 aspirational districts with the collaboration of DASH. Surakshit Hum Surakshit Tum. We protected, you protected. Okay. Surakshit Hum Surakshit Tum means we protected, you protected. If we are protected, then you are also protected. Okay. Basically. So, thoda grammatical error ho gaya tha pehle wale sentence mein. Please pardon that. So you have to tell Niti Aayog has launched Surakshit Hum Surakshit Tum Abhiyan in 112 aspirational district with the collaboration of that, with the collaboration of DASH. So let me tell you the answer here. The correct answer to this question is Piramal Foundation. सो इन कोलैबोरेशन विद पिरामिल फाउंडेशन नीति आयोग हैज लॉन्च्ड सुरक्षित हम सुरक्षित तुम अभियान इन 112 एस्पिरेशनल डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स. नाउ व्हाई दिस अभियान दिस प्रोग्राम हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड. सो दिस इज फॉर असिस्टिंग द एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन इन प्रोवाइडिंग होम केयर सपोर्ट टू द कोविड पेशेंट्स हु आर आइदर एसिम्प्टोमैटिक्स और हैविंग माइल्ड सिम्टम्स. ऐसे पेशेंट्स कोविड के जो कि एसिम्प्टोमैटिक हैं या फिर उनको माइल्ड सिम्टम है, तो उनको सपोर्ट प्रोवाइड कराया जाएगा घर में ही बिठा के, और उसके लिए एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन को असिस्टेंस प्रोवाइड कराई जाएगी थ्रू दिस अभियान, थ्रू दिस प्रोग्राम. ऑलराइट. एंड द कैंपेन गाइस इज एक्सपेक्टेड टू प्ले अ की रोल इन डिस्ट्रिक्ट प्रिपेयरनेस फॉर मैनेजिंग नियरली 70% ऑफ कोविड केसेस एट होम एंड दैट विल डेफिनेटली रिड्यूस द प्रेशर ऑन द हेल्थ केयर सिस्टम. अब हर किसी को हॉस्पिटल जाने की जरूरत नहीं होती कोविड में, एज वी ऑल नो. तो घर पे ही अगर हम प्रॉपरली ध्यान रखें तो अच्छे से ट्रीटमेंट की जा सकती है. इट विल ऑल्सो प्रोवाइड लॉन्ग टर्म सपोर्ट टू इंडियाज पुएस्ट कम्युनिटीज इन द एस्पिरेशनल डिस्ट्रिक्ट बाई एड्रेसिंग द लास्टिंग इम्पैक्ट ऑफ कोविड-19. बिकॉज जो यहाँ के एस्पिरेशनल डिस्ट्रिक्ट के लोग हैं, दे आर ऑल्सो नॉट अवेयर अबाउट हाउ वी कैन टैकल दिस कोविड-19. सो दिस प्रोजेक्ट विल ऑल्सो प्रोवाइड अवेयरनेस, दे विल ऑल्सो हेल्प इन द ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ कोविड-19. ओके. एंड दिस प्रोग्राम विल बी लेड बाई डी एम्स इन पार्टनरशिप विद ओवर 1,000 लोकल NGOs. And these local NGOs will provide training to the volunteers. And how many volunteers? Over 1 lakh volunteers will be provide training to connect with the patients through inbound or outbound calls. And these volunteers will be trained to support 20 affected families each. Yani ki ek volunteer 20 families ko support provide karega by educating caretakers to follow protocols, provide psychosocial support and other timely updates about the patients to the administration. Okay. So this is about this program, Surakshit Hum Surakshit Tum, and option A, Pyramid Foundation, as I told you, is the correct answer. And that's it for the session, guys. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Milte hain Monday ke session mein. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.